Welcome back. Well, at least 1,000 firefighters are battling a massive fire in Victoria's west. Hundreds of residents have been told to evacuate now as the blaze approaches town.
It was a nasty afternoon. Yeah. A Country Fire Authority Chief Officer Jason Heffernan joins us live from Melbourne. Jason, good morning to you. What's the latest on the ground this morning?
Good morning, Carl and Sarah. Look, the conditions this morning, unfortunately, are escalating again. The Bayandine fire, which we hoped was going to settle down after midnight last night, didn't. And we are continuing to see a northerly progression of that fire, sufficiently so that very short moment ago, we've just issued another emergency alert for Elmhurst. We've also issued, emergency warning with emergency alert issued for Elmhurst to leave now. That advice has gone out through the Vic Emergency app and some 5,000 text messages have gone out around those communities. Today we were hoping we're going to be a bit milder, and whilst we'll see milder temperatures around 18 degrees, unfortunately those southwesterly winds are still going to remain quite high around 30 to 45, which will continue to drive that fire in a northerly direction and being quite challenging for firefighters. Additional resources are making their way to the fire grounds it will be a challenging day, but this morning's effort and concern is for the community of Elmhurst, and they have just been advised to leave now. Relief centres are still established at the Wendaree Football Club, at Moratar Avenue in Ararat, and a new one has been established in Park Road in Maryborough for any communities of Elmhurst looking for a relief centre.
Yeah, Jase, it is really challenging. I mean, these pictures we're looking at now are terrifying. I was in Melbourne yesterday and it was bushfire conditions, wasn't it? Really hot, really dry, that wind swirling. And then obviously that late wind change kind of forced you to change your focus as well. So far, no homes have been lost. Are you hopeful that will remain today?
I'm not hopeful, unfortunately. We are already starting to receive early intelligence of some property loss from the crews that are around the fire ground last night. And just given the sheer size of the fire, some 10,000 hectares as we currently speak, I will not be surprised whether we see a number of homes, but also significant numbers of sheds, outbuildings, stock losses and fence losses for our farming community. You're right, those temperatures yesterday, the early 40s, those really strong, hot northerly winds. But then came that wind change, and our concern was around that wind change.
Yeah.
And that saw that fire being driven then under 80 kilometre an hour winds.
Oy.
And that's what's been pushing this fire overnight.
Oh, sorry, I was just looking at these images.
Yeah,
I can't believe there's
images,
just incredible pictures. There's still pictures and the accounts from people on the ground yesterday afternoon that I was listening to on 3AW. It's a very serious situation and a very stressful one.
It is for all communities, and my message to anyone who lives west of Ballarat today is have the Vic Emergency app with you all day. Make sure you've got it on your mobile phone. Constantly check it. Have your watch zone set and follow direction of authorities. Remember, always have two sources of information, the Vic Emergency app or the Vic Emergency website, or listen to your emergency broadcaster. I do expect today's conditions to be milder than yesterday, but the condition is still volatile for communities in and around the Bayandine fire, and particularly for the communities around Elmhurst this morning.
All right, you got a lot of boots on the ground. I appreciate you being with us today. Thank you.
Bushfire in Victoria's west has scorched through 10,000 hectares of land, with hundreds of residents evacuated. Today, Melbourne reporter Christine Ahern has the details for us. Chris, good morning. Firefighters have been battling the blaze throughout the night.
Yeah, that's right, Brooke. This fire actually broke out yesterday morning, and firefighters have been battling to get it under control. As we go to air, there is an emergency warning to leave immediately issued for the town of Beaufort and surrounds. That is located about 40 kilometres northwest of Ballarat. Because of a wind change last night, there was a watch and act to leave now issued for the town of Lexton and surrounds as this bushfire pushes north. There is already about, as you mentioned, 10,000 hectares that has been burnt. This bushfire is not under control as of yet. 1,000 firefighters have been battling this blaze on the ground, 24 aircraft battling it from above. Hundreds of residents have already evacuated to relief centres located in Ararat and Ballarat. Emergency services telling me this morning it is just too early to know if any properties have been lost, but as you can imagine, that has meant an anxious night for so many residents.
it was a bit daunting at first, just sort of seeing it, but then as we saw the app and everything, and then as we're asked to evacuate, seeing the little spot fires appearing all around and thinking, yeah, it's a bit more serious than we thought, sort of coming up over Mount Cole and thinking, well, if the wind's pushing this way, it's going to threaten us, but we can only do what we were told. So, yeah, we're out here and we'll leave it in the hands of God, I suppose.
Here in Melbourne, the cool change brought much relief from that stifling heat late yesterday with the mercury in the high 30s, early 40s. Thankfully, the storms that came with it weren't as severe as last week, but power is still a problem. The state government said as of late yesterday, an extra 2,000 properties were without power as a result of the wild weather. That's on top of the 600 properties still without power from the severe storms 10 days ago. Brooke.
All right, thanks, Chris.
Two